Yo, what's going on, guys? JBH here, and today I'm back on NASCAR Heat 4, where we're continuing on this sort of weekend at the Phoenix Raceway. Now, yesterday in the Xfinity Series, managed to have a top 15 result. It was kind of a little bit sort of lackluster in terms of our pace, especially over the long run. I virtually tried to make a cup setup work in an Xfinity Series car, and it didn't go well. So today was a little bit more practice. Now, I'm just going to jump into a quick qualifying session, hopefully get this Mustang somewhere up towards the front, and then we'll jump straight into the race after that. Okay, so qualifying is run and done. We managed to qualify on the front row, although we were second. We were only 0.004 of a second off the pole, so there's nothing in it. Now, I've tried to do a little bit in practice and get this set up better on the long run. I struggled a lot yesterday in the Xfinity Series on the long run. It was just loose after like five laps. We had something like a 30% right front to right rear differential in tire wear after like 20 laps, so I'm a little bit worried that that's going to be the same today, but I've tightened up this race setup, so I'm hoping it should be okay. Alrighty, well, that's enough talk. Let's get this race underway. Phoenix Raceway, or ISM Raceway. I can't remember what it's called now. On NASCAR Heat 4, we got Kurt Busch on the pole. This is the Ticket Garden 500. It's going to be a long one. Beautiful Mustang. Do love the Fords. All right, here we go. Starting on the dog leg. This is the first. I mean, besides yesterday in the Xfinity Series, but a bit different. My racing always started sort of coming off of whatever you call this corner. I don't even know what the turn numbers are anymore. This thing is tight. So what I found is you've got to sort of set your car up based on where you want to run on track, because obviously above the apron is a little bit more banked than below it. So I've set my car to run up here because it's a lot loose below the apron. A lot more loose, I should say. Let's see if we can gap these guys without using up too much of the tire. Another thing as well, that's the most famous sort of aspect of Phoenix, is the dogleg, and the AI do not seem to go above it, which is very realistic. Now, as I say in all my NASCAR Heat 4 videos, I do apologize for any stutters. I don't know what it is with this game, I just cannot get it running smooth. So will be a little bit of frame weight, questionable frame rates at some point. It would seem that our qualifying pace is a lot better than our race pace, which is what I expected. I can set the car up to be really good over one lap, but I struggled to get the car up on any sort of decent balance over a full fuel run. As you see, I've had to set it up really tight. No matter what, that right rear is going to wear out. You can see we're already at a 10% difference. It's only been 10 laps. Let Kurt have this lead for now.
Still there inside. All clear. Tower called a caution.
We've got our first caution.
Drive safe, be smart. Keep your head on straight. Almost ready. Green's out, man. Let's go. Inside. We've got 20 more laps.
20 laps to go.
You got room. You're clear there. Looking inside now. Clear down low.
One thing I did learn in the Xfinity race is that track position is more important than getting new tires around here, because it's just so hard to sort of pass and then make it stick. So just sit here, I'll try and bottom if I can.
Hold your line, got one inside. You got room, you're clear there. Hold your line, got one inside.
Anything coming off of the turn of the door or whatever it is.
Still there inside. clear high.
I've screwed it up.
Still bad. Looking inside now. Hold your line, got one inside. Close clear.
Oh, crap. Still man, there, this thing inside. Is getting really loose.
Still
so
bad.
Who's on the loop?
Hold your line, got one inside.
Kurt Busch behind us.
Inside, inside. 10 laps to go.
Guys, we are going backwards like a ton of bricks right now.
Car there on the inside.
Tight it was in that corner just then, yet for some stupid reason I'm still wearing the rears out like no tomorrow. And I wish they fixed that for Heat 5, because it's just so unrealistic, you know. It's like 31-32% now.
Anyway.
14th in stage one. This is going to be a struggle street day if we're stuck doing these long runs. But
starter has the green flag in his hand. Almost ready now.
Right, here we go. Stage two. Outside. I haven't made any changes. Just going to pass half the field here under the dog leg. Just see how it goes, because I just don't know what I can change. I've changed just about everything in practice.
Still
there.
Car high, careful. Still there.
Get on that.
Got one down low now.
Go away, you racist prick.
Got one inside.
Oh my god, just getting... I've bombed. Inside. Dang it, man.
Hold your line, stay high. Got a car coming inside now. You got room, you're clear.
Got a turn.
Hold your
itch.
Line, got one inside.
This car is pissing me off.
Got a car coming inside now. Got room,
I just had to get down to the bottom, or else we were going straight to the back. I'm actually doing alright until we got dive bombed by like Larson and Truex. Bro, he's literally spun out even though I gave him such a big bump draft that he's got into that corner so hot the AI has just been like, nope. Can't handle it. Oh, that was kind of funny. Ah, short tracks. Well, yes. I guess you could sort of call this a mini short track.
Stay low, stay low.
Always cause chaos.
You're all clear up top. Careful, still there.
Back inside the top 15. Driving like shit, I'm driving like shit, I'm driving like shit, cause I'm driving like shit, I'm driving like shit. We've got 10 laps to go, and the entire pack in front of us is all battling for a second. So I'm going to attempt to try and drive like shit. Get some of them. I think we're starting to lose the grip of the tyre, so even though they're all on much older tyres than we are, we're starting to lose that advantage. Oh, big wreck! Hard into the wall! Look at Truex. Let's go. Shit, we've gone to second. So Tyler Reddick next to us. He's jumped probably from last. Oh my god, this is going to be sketchy. We've got 7 laps to get this thing to the finish of stage 2 and get a win. Feeling everyone's got much newer tyres than us. We've got to get away. Oh, here comes Harvick. He had a, Newman had a huge lead before this caution came out. Oh, there's two.
Got a car coming inside now.
Five to go. This week, we hope to get some points in this stage. We just keep this Mustang where it is. Hello.
Stay on the bottom. Still there inside.
We're 3 wide. No.
Clear low, bud. Looking inside now.
Shit. Go away.
3 wide.
Someone's spinning. We're wrecking. Alright, well, we finished third, but I was 3 wide, and I think someone dive bombed me, and I don't even know what happened there, but we'll grab a top 3. I'm going to pit. Everyone is going to stay out, but I'm going to fill a full of fuel. Should have more tires than everyone else.
Keep your head on straight. Be ready. Car on the outside now.
Right, now we have got 82 laps to go.
You got room. You're clear there. All right, you're clear there.
So this will be a long run to the finish.
Oh, got one peeking outside.
That was a bit rude. In, but yeah, just about ran into everyone today, so not too worried about it.
Stay on the bottom. Still there.
Thankfully, NASCAR don't got no rules. We can do what we want. The time I'm recording this is Memorial Day weekend, so the Coke 600 is just about to start. And the last race, Kyle Busch completely annihilated old mate J. Chase Elliott, and they were not the best of friends afterwards, but as far as I'm concerned, I don't think Bush has been awarded a penalty for that. And that just goes to show there are literally no rules in NASCAR. I mean, the amount of times I've seen people get wrecked and nothing happen, I mean, you can literally get away with anything. Unless it's not, like, driving backwards on the racetrack and endangering people's lives. Actually, no, you can still endanger people's lives, you just can't go backwards on the racetrack. Gaining spots slowly but surely. We have got more tires than the rest, so
it's slightly easier. You're all clear up top. The race is half over. Stay low.
Too hard on these Goodyears. Oh, that's
right. Still there?
Ripping these things too early. Tad Dillon. Adjustment to the wedge, have loosened it up a little bit, and it's definitely made us faster in this part of the race. It's just how long before we lose all this rear grip. I mean, it's only been 10 laps, but we're still charging through the field, so I'm happy with it so far. Oh, Jesus. Man, he just shot to the right.
All right, you're clear.
Okay. Man, this AI around here is difficult to deal with. We'll just about run into everyone. Still got like 70 or 60 laps to go. Let's go.
Inside now.
Slap. bad job. There. Jimmy.
Still there.
Oh, Jesus. Yeah, and there's another caution. All right, well, we're going to pit because the tires are screwed, but
almost ready.
We're all on the same rubber now.
Green flag.
So should be interesting. Ryan, let's go.
Careful, still there. You got a car low now. Looking inside now.
Gotta get to the bottom.
Inside.
Just squeeze in front of Jimmy.
Got
one peeking outside. All right, you're clear there. All clear. Stay low. Attempted start job. Didn't really work.
Your line, got one outside. All right, you're clear. Car high, careful there. You got room, you're clear there. Careful, still there. You're clear there.
Slow job. Just about got him. Inside the top 10.
You got room, you're clear there.
Big wreck. Kurt's in the wall.
Ready
just
now.
Gonna get to the bottom.
Green.
Oh, Jesus, that's a decent jump. You!
Careful, still there.
Too deep. Keep this number 9 car behind me, he's too quick.
Got one peeking inside. Car there on the inside.
Oh, that was tight.
Car there on the inside.
No, go away, Kurt. Ah, oh, shit. Okay, that's weird. I thought I left him enough room, obviously.
Inside.
Oh, go away. Oh, we're getting dumped.
Got one outside now. You got room. You're clear.
Damn it. 5 to go. 6 to go. Racing.
Clear eye.
Oh my god, it's gonna be 3 wide.
Outside. Hold your line, man, 3 wide.
Traffic.
Oh,
caution! Oh, what do we do? What do we do? God,
three laps to go. Not the pit. Oh, I was thinking about it, but it's just, it's too hard to pass around here. Anyway, green, white checkered. We're starting in eighth, so we've got to get down to the bottom as fast as possible. We had to do it. Send it! Oh, shit! Someone tagged Kurt. Oh, it's not going well. Yeah, Jesus!
Got one outside now.
Oh. Brie Larson, no. No.
Alright, let's go. White flag. Careful, still there. Got one outside now. Top three, use it if you need it.
I got the grip.
Still there.
No.
Got one peeking inside.
Oh, no. Sake. Right, well, I cocked that up big time. Damn it, we're running eighth. Screwed it up. May as well have started from the back. Pitted on that last stop. Anyway, that's not one of my finer moments, but I have to just live with it. Yeah, anyway, guys, thanks for tuning in. I hope you enjoyed the video. Not one of the best results in the world, but we'll move on to the next one. Next one, I believe, is Bristol. That's going to be up next week. Hopefully, we can get a good result at the Coliseum, I believe it's called. All right, until then, I'll catch you guys later.